Welcome one and all to this qualifier one preview between the Mumbai Indians and the Delhi Capitals. We here have the TSD team to preview it. Prathamesh and Anurag joining me here. We'll start with Prathamesh, Mumbai Indians, who come in as the resounding favorites into this playoff phase of this tournament. And they do take on a Delhi team who've lost their last two matches in this venue, the Dubai Cricket Stadium, that is. How do you see this match panning out, Prathamesh? And any fitness concerns that you might have with Mumbai, or any concerns over form or anything like that? Because it is very difficult to pick holes into that squad.
Yeah, you talked about Delhi losing the last two Dubai games. I think Mumbai only won one in Dubai, so that in itself is
not a happy ground for either
much
teams.
All about, yeah, not a happy ground for either teams. I think. The
middle ground, not a problem.
Yeah, it's a middle ground. So that's a proper neutral venue for both the sides. Talking about fitness concerns, I think Rohit Sharma has just, you know, put out all the concerns by himself, saying that he's fit enough to play the rest of the IPL. So I think that in itself is really reassuring for Mumbai Indians. Probably the only one concern in the entire setup of the 11 players was Saurabh Tiwari. And no offense to Saurabh Tiwari, he played well in the first couple of games which he played, but then he's not the top quality material that the rest of the 10 players in Mumbai are in the lineup. So, you know, Rohit coming back makes a lot. It gives a massive moral as well as, you know, collective run scoring boost for the MI batting lineup. It gives the likes of Ishan Kishan a little more freedom to play with. You know, that's something that they will really be taking into consideration with Pollard and Hardik. You know, it's almost like you look at every department, you know, opening the batting, there's that middle overs where you settle the batting down, where you settle the innings down. You look at the end, you look at the opening the bowling, those middle overs and finishing the game off. I think Mumbai tick all the boxes. The only problem with Mumbai sometimes is that they create situations for themselves which, you know, they shouldn't be doing, in the sense of they sometimes just overthink situations and work them out a bit too much in their own brain. And then, you know, it doesn't really go well. I think one thing that did happen in the RCB game, I felt especially that Mumbai Indians just, you know, overthought the entire situation, did a Pep Guardiola of it. So I think that is one concern for me, that with Mahela, with Zaheer, with Pollard and Rohit, there are so many brilliant heads in show, but then you don't want to, you know, make it such a spicy dish that nobody is able to eat it after all. So that is the major concern. But otherwise, I think Mumbai, even though they have had not such a good record in Dubai, their last win in Dubai was against DC. Very convincing win, very convincing batting and bowling performance. So that should keep them in good stead for the qualifier.
All right. We come to you, Anurag, talking about their opponents. Of course, Delhi Capitals, who must have been so relieved to get that victory over RCB, though it was a thoroughly deserved victory. You know, it was a very good performance, both by their bowlers, and it was so heartening to see Ajinkya Rahane come back. I was annoyed with the ridiculous shot that he played to get out, but up until that shot, it was a pretty chanceless innings. You know, it was, you know, that I remember Ruturaj Gaikwad had played a similar shot.
Yeah.
Just comes to the, raises back to the cover side and holds his pose. Right? You know, that's a classic Rahane shot, right? I saw him play that shot versus.
Yesterday, even Saha played that shot. I mean, not to the fluency of Rahane, but yeah.
But yes. So I just love watching that.
Absolutely.
Shot. How do you see this Delhi side shaping up? Surely Mumbai are the favorites. I mean, let's not kid ourselves. Let's not kid anyone. I think Mumbai are the most complete squad in the tournament. But does this Delhi team have a chance? Does it have a shot to maybe surprise a few people?
They ideally should be, you know, because they have the talent, they have the manpower. If not, see, what separates the Delhi manpower and the Mumbai manpower as a form, and the individual quality that they have put out rather than just what they have on paper. If Delhi had continued how they were playing in the first eight games, I think we would have been calling shots on Mumbai and Delhi. I think we could have been having an argument as to who, which team had the better individual resources, and we both could have had immensely great points. And that's where Delhi eventually, you know, if in the last game that you were mentioning, it's either a flat or a draw. I think that's the problem.
Yeah.
And again, in the RCB game, I think there was so too many things running in their mind. Firstly, once they got that start, I think they just wanted to get over the line. They did not want to get into that 17.3 mark and to do anyone a favor. They didn't. They were not obliged to anyways. They wanted to get over the line. They didn't want to take any risks. I think they saw that phase very beautifully from a Delhi perspective. I know Kolkata fans would absolutely hate to listen this. But from a Delhi perspective, they got that thing covered. I think for a phase of 6-7 overs, there were like 3-4 dot balls. And every ball, there was a single, there was a double. I think once you get that strike rotation going, no, it'll irrelevant of which format you, the bowlers are going to be pissed. The bowlers are not that pissed when the batsmen are going for shots. They're even
because you're hitting 1-4 out of 3 deliveries.
Yeah, and when a batsman is attacking, there is a chance you could get a wicket as well. When the batsmen are playing such risk-free cricket and with such class, it's almost impossible to get them out. And Rahane, he did such a good job that game, and he exactly fits. Again, if was this game in Dubai? I think it was in Abu Dhabi, right?
I think it was Abu Dhabi.
Yeah, I think this was in Abu Dhabi. So we don't know how the conditions might pan out in Dubai, because we've seen different patterns as we've discussed in the just before we started this video. So there were a couple of games where the team batting first put a mountainous score, and again the team batting second found it very difficult as the pitch slowed down. And there were other games where Dew came into picture and second was not very easy. So it's been sort of a, you know, very different sort of a ground this time. You can't really come to a conclusion as far as stats is concerned. You have to wait for that day to see what is going to happen. And as far as Delhi is concerned, I really hope Prithvi Shaw finds some touchback. You know, he's one of those players who's going to... you see a little bit of Sehwag in him. I know people will, no, don't do that. But yeah, see, he has that a little bit in him. He wants to...
I wish he had the cricketing brains of Sehwag.
Exactly, yeah.
I'm sorry. Sehwag is one of the most street smart and competitive cricketers.
And
I've
I think among all the
life.
Yeah, among all the aggressive cricketers,
and the guts,
I think the most.
It was not just aggressiveness, Anurag. It was the guts
and the smartness.
Yeah,
and the smartness as well. I think that's what he has to inculcate from the man. See, he has that metal. You know, the thing that I find common about these two is they both play aggressive cricket by playing ground shots. They keep
and
the scoreboard moving, and that's where I think Prithvi Shaw has some more areas to work on. I think he still is a fabulous talent. I will not. I know plenty of people have written him away. I will not do that quite as yet. He's scored 21-22. Come on, yeah.
And what
so,
story this time? What a story it would be! What a story it would be for a Mumbai lad, against Mumbai, as Ajinkya Rahane does this every time to Mumbai Indians, just to remind the Mumbai Indians setup why they let him go in the first place.
See, again, this is
what
now Delhi won a game which was must-win for them to get to the top two. That is a good start. Now there is a great chance to bank upon that. I hope they do, because that's when, otherwise we don't want to see another roller coaster. I mean, we want to see another roller coaster of a game, not just a one-way traffic. I think that would be incredibly boring from a neutral fan perspective.
And we need not even kid ourselves, because at the start of the tournament, we did think that Delhi was the most complete squad in the IPL.
Exactly, yes.
Along with
yes.
Mumbai. So no matter what has happened past now, on the day if these guys really show up, Mumbai will have a tough time. Yeah. It is not a ride home for Mumbai anyway. I think what it gives with the qualifier one, what it gives both teams is a chance to actually, you know, it gives them an opportunity to fail, which sometimes can be a negative mindset, you know, where you have that opportunity to fail. So, you know, even if
you might not be giving 100%. Yeah,
exactly. So that's something that we need to consider. And with both coaches, Mahela and Ricky Ponting, being aggressive all the time, with both captains having that aggression, you know, that probably that comes from the street cricket in Mumbai, with, you know, the both teams being as complete as they possibly could in the IPL, I think it's going to be a fabulous, fabulous match. And with both teams not having a good record at Dubai, it spices things up even more.
Yeah.
And, you know, just as the final predictions from your end, Prathamesh, do you see, of course, I think it's a stupid question to ask you. Do you see any changes in the playing 11? Because I think Mumbai are more consistent than a drain track.
Yeah.
I do see Rangers in the playing 11. I see Hardik Pandya coming on for Saurabh.
Oh, come on, man. You know, as I was talking about the 11 that generally starts, Hardik's a part of the 11, of course.
Yeah.
I think
it's given. The 11 that played in the game prior to the game against Sunrisers, I think that will pretty much be the 11.
Not even the game that, I think Hardik's been rested for 2 matches. So the match even before that.
Hardik will,
so Rohit
come,
wasn't
in,
there,
will come in and bolt, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Exactly. So probably, yeah. So we will see Rohit open with QDK. We will see Ishan Kishan, Surya. We will see Hardik, Pollard, Krunal. We will see Rahul Chahar and the three really good bowlers in Pattinson, Bolt, Bumrah. Pretty much settled. There is no question of even tweaking. If they put in Coulter Nile, then it's going to be a big question mark on the setup.
No, I don't think Coulter Nile's. I don't even yesterday Coulter Nile wasn't really good.
Yeah.
Anurag, any surprise additions that you might see from the Delhi side? I think they need to play Ajinkya Rahane and they need to you know slap some sense into Shreyas Iyer.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm just looking at their team and I'm just wondering what is the change that they could potentially do. I think. Daniel Sams is the only person you could see and question maybe will he be in the 11 or not. Besides that, I think this is pretty much the same 11.
So who did Daniel Sams replace? I'm not
Hetmyer.
Oh, he replaced Hetmyer, yeah.
To add another bowling option, I think that is the reason.
I think in Dubai, considering how they failed was Mumbai with their batting, I think they would be better served taking a batsman more, right?
Yeah, but again, that'll make Marcus Stoinis their fifth bowler. So they might have to change something with the Indian contingent, which is at this point is not incredible, not suggestible, I would say. And yeah, Daniel Sams also came in with Prithvi Shaw coming in because I think there was some Indian bowler I think Tushar Deshpande was a person who went out. So again, I think this is a very good 11, the last game. Daniel Sams, as I questioned it, but I think that's pretty much good. He can swing the ball. And we've seen some lateral movement in at least a little bit in Dubai. So if that is available, so you never know. I think that's a good 11. So I hope they go with the same one.
Yeah, what are your predictions for the match?
This is, I think, you know, you can go with a prediction for any football game where, you know, there are so many topsy-turvy aspects to consider. This is so difficult. An IPL qualifier is so difficult to call. But ideally, it should be Mumbai Indians, but you know, that's not something you can say with 100% conviction. But ideally, yeah, it should be Mumbai.
Pratne, should I even ask you?
I think there's no point asking. I think the only prediction that I'm going to make is Jasprit Bumrah picks up more wickets in the match than Kagiswara Bada.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I think. How far behind Bumrah is in the book?
On par, just economy.
Economy, yeah.
Just economy. Oh, yeah. God. Oh.
Rabada, I think it's one wicket as well. I think it was one wicket as well. It's one wicket.
I'm sorry. 23.
It stands, it's 25 to Rabada and 23 to Bumrah.
Yeah.
23. Yeah, 25. So. This is two wickets. Okay. All right. Thank you, lads. I think both of them realistically, both of you realistically would hope, would think, no, I won't say hope, would think that Mumbai would win. Yeah. Here is me. I mean, I'm hoping, you know, Delhi pull off a miracle because I don't want Delhi to go through that, qualifier eliminator.
Me too. I think a new winner would do great to the IPL.
I still think if somehow Delhi is able to pull it off, Mumbai will crash everyone
else
and still come to the final. Just have that kind of annoying feeling.
It's almost, I think the biggest prediction would, my biggest prediction would be, I think these two will be in the final again. That's my prediction.
Last 7 years, this has happened, right? Out of 8 years, this happened. 1, 2... Have we been invariably reached the final? So let's see if that trend continues. Thank you so much for joining me here, guys. And thank you so much to all of our viewers for watching this video. Do put in your comments in the comment section below and let us know what do you think, how the match will go and who the important players would be. And of course, how do you think all the other matches have been and all the other remaining matches will go as well. So thank you so much for watching. Share this video around with your friends and with your acquaintances. Let them know and let us know if they've got any comments on our behalf as well. Thank you so much, guys, for joining me here. And let's hope the qualifying is a nail biting match, regardless of the finish. Thank you so much, guys.